Well, that's the summary of your issues. And this is where your time is wasted.
Yes, but now, tell me about this Delhi game.
Aha.
Now, I have to be comfortable. I really don't know.
How to delegate?
Maybe you should teach him, sir.
Well, we were ready for that too. Time permitting, you're ready for that. So, if you bear with us for the next few minutes, yes, we can give you a few tips on delegation. Let's start with delegation. Delegation starts with you. Before you delegate work, it's important that you organize yourself. You cannot organize other people till you organize yourself. So, what should you be doing in organizing yourself? The most basic requirement in organizing yourself is first listing down what you're supposed to do. I don't think I can make it simpler than that.
What's a maximizer, Stefan?
Well, that's something that we have not signed a term of reference yet on a certain amount of knowledge that we're supposed to impart in this program.
Oh, I see. Right, okay.
Yeah. That's for the future. What am I here for? You need to understand the purpose of your job. I believe by now you've got some sort of idea that you need to spend more time on improvement and less amount of time on running around. And that's exactly, if you remember, I mentioned to you in this grid, you have to spend at least 60-70% of your time in creation, building new businesses. True enough, I believe you saw the contract of Sultan Brothers. Well, I believe is a good contract, but the fact is you should be spending more time on these kinds of things, not the little things. You need to establish your priorities in what is important and what is urgent. This seems to be constantly, we seem to be having an issue about what is important and urgent. Well, if you look at an important job, it's a job which is linked to your responsibilities. For example, if your responsibility is innovation in the business, if that is your core responsibility, then a job that is important is jobs that are in lines of those. And there's a big difference between something being important and urgent. For example, sometimes you will find that if a job is important, you need to give it a lot of time. And you need to plan ahead for it. But if a job becomes important and urgent, then you have a problem. Why? Obviously, you have not planned it, and suddenly it lands on your desk, and you have very little time to put for it. So what kind of result or quality do we expect from that kind of work? And also, there are jobs that are urgent, but they are very trivial. You don't have to spend a lot of time doing this. Just spend 5-10 minutes, finish it, and just get on with it. So that's how you could basically approach in organizing yourself. So if you organize yourself, then let's see how you can organize other people.
Stefan, I think you have a story about this.
Yeah, it's an age-old story. I think you've heard it before, but let's remind ourselves about it. I think when the St. Paul's Cathedral was built, there was three people on this website. One was very lazy. There was a guy who was kind of mean, where he was reasonably energetic. And there was this third guy who was very energetic. So this guy was walking past the site, was wondering, people from the same country, doing the same job, how come there are different levels of motivation? So he went across this guy who was lazy and asked him, what are you doing here? He said, well, I am laying bricks. Then the second guy who was a little bit more energetic and asked, what are you doing? I said, I am building a very strong wall. And then the third guy asked, he was working very energetically, asked him, what are you doing here? He said, well, I'm building a beautiful cathedral that's going to last 100 years. So this is putting purpose into minds of people, inspiring them to work, so that they don't feel it's work.
That's what they're talking about.
So this doesn't happen in 5 minutes. It requires time, it requires passion. It's important that we saw all around that people are falling short of expectations. And there's no better word to define this by setting standards. I think standards is something that we all talk about. You can set your standards in lines of at least 3-4 of these areas we're talking about. It can be in the areas of quality, in the areas of quantity, in the areas of time, and in the areas of cost. You can combine all these together, or you can have separate standards in when you're measuring a job. And it's very important that constantly you keep resolving your shortfalls. It's also important that you agree on your targets. Now, standards and targets, well, sometimes it gets very confused. Now, sometimes people automatically use these words standards and targets. Now, for example, if you look at an employee who is skilled, who can perform certain amount of activities in a certain given time, okay, maybe he can do 70% or 80%, but if you recruit a trainee, what do you expect from that person? The standard may be 60 or 70%, but when it comes to training, you might be reducing your target. And sometimes when the employee gets skilled, you might even keep the standard and increase the target beyond 70%.
But that doesn't mean even for a training that you don't give any work, isn't it?
You give work, but you have to understand the capacity of the training. It's not like sending a trainee to wait. Also, it's important that you review your responsibilities. This is an area that you're falling very, very short of. You're reviewing your responsibilities, your controls, as if your plans are as good as your controls. And finally, if you've done all that, yeah, you're dealing with humans, so it's important that praise people. When I saw this praise coming out from you at work, I believe there was not much of achievement for praise.